Hey there, I'm Tom Marshburn, an astronaut living and working aboard the International Space Station, the sole space-based proving ground and stepping stone for NASA's Artemis program. Have you ever wondered how astronauts up here get fresh, breathable oxygen? The answer might surprise you. Come on, follow me, and let's check it out. The oxygen we breathe comes from recycled water. The water recovery system recycles wastewater that takes the form of urine, sweat, and condensation, and pumps it into the oxygen generator system, or OGS. When the water reaches the OGS, it goes through a process called electrolysis. Electrolysis is the process of creating a chemical reaction by passing an electric current through an electrolyte, which is a solution containing ions. This means to decompose water, an energy source like a battery is necessary. We're taking water and breaking it down into its two components, hydrogen gas and oxygen gas. The law of conservation of mass states that matter is neither created nor destroyed in a chemical reaction. This means that the number of atoms in the reactant side must be equal to the same number of atoms on the product side of the equation. Notice how once balanced, the number of atoms in the reactants is equal to the number of atoms in the products. The oxygen produced from this chemical reaction is vented back to us and the main cabin so we can breathe and continue our work up here. The hydrogen gas produced from the chemical reaction is combined with the carbon dioxide we exhale to generate water and methane. The methane produced from this chemical reaction is vented into space, and the water feeds back into the OGS, completing a regenerative life support cycle. So being able to recycle water is absolutely essential for us living aboard the space station. Turns out water is very heavy. You don't want to have to carry it up every time you deliver a crew to the space station. So what we do is we recycle our water, up to 93% of the water here, and using the technology we have now. To spend a lot of time in orbit around the moon and on the lunar surface and to go to Mars, we need to be able to recycle 98% of the water, which is what we are doing right now, investigating new technologies in order to be able to accomplish a 98% recycle rate. So in the air right now around us is moisture that comes off of our bodies, and that is captured in the air conditioning systems over here to my right and to my left. You can probably hear the air conditioning system. And that captures the moisture coming from our bodies and from some free fluids we might have floating around. That goes to the water recovery system along with our urine. And then through a process of electrolysis, we're able to create oxygen. Not only do we save on the water, but we're able to produce that vital constituent that's important for, essential for us to live. I hope you learned a little bit more about chemical reactions and the law of conservation of mass today. Now it's your turn to practice what you've learned using the corresponding classroom connection. As you can see, conservation of mass is pretty important on Earth and in space. See you next time.